7 is more than buildings.
It's more than computers.
More than labs.
More than the latest technology.
7 is more than athletic fields. These walls, they don't define me.
It's too low or too...
7 is a place that challenges us to be our best selves.
Hello!
More than a place, 7 is a nurturing environment, a community.
Make sure you have a continuous conducting path. We inspire our students to discover what matters in their lives and education.
You just finished...
To speak and act with respect and to stand up for what is right.
Okay, so what are we talking about?
Intense debate teaches self-control and the courage to take on difficult issues.
Do you think we'd have to take action?
Like, I don't know if that would help. I think that could affect us down the road for sure.
Keep it a secret, but they're learning.
Learning together, learning about respect, learning how to acquire knowledge, learning what matters and why it is important.
It's really fun to do these experiments.
We learn about the things we see every day, about the way the world works.
Climbing.
The kids get inspired. What they learn in class brings the world around them to life. It's exciting for them and for me.
You play for each other, you play for your families, you play for that name that's on the front of your jersey right now. Leave it all on the field, man. Let's go, baby.
Athletics foster community. We learn from our setbacks, and together we celebrate our victories.
We study hard and we play hard.
We're also creative. Fine arts, dramatics, and music.
Curtis Lumpkin, you're being places!
The arts challenge our students, expanding who they are. They're gaining new skills and learning new talents that they didn't even know they had.
There's a lot going on, so we need to know how to take care of ourselves.
You know, exercise, eating well, meditation, and time management.
We count on each other.
We reach out to help each other.
We are part of a community.
And most important, the thread of integrity runs through everything we do. We're very proud of what we have here at 7. But buildings alone do not create a school. It's our community.
7 is so much more than I imagined. This is my place, my community.
At 7 School, we believe there are many ways to lead, and that each child has the potential to be exceptional. Because when we define leadership as the positive impact you can have on another person, we become the empathetic, dynamic people that ultimately the world will depend.
We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
7 is more than buildings.
It's more than computers.
More than labs.
More than the latest technology.
7 is more than athletic fields. These walls, they don't define me.
It's too low or too...
7 is a place that challenges us to be our best selves.
Hello!
More than a place, 7 is a nurturing environment, a community.
Make sure you have a continuous conducting path. We inspire our students to discover what matters in their lives and education.
You just finished...
To speak and act with respect and to stand up for what is right.
Okay, so what are we talking about?
Intense debate teaches self-control and the courage to take on difficult issues.
Do you think we'd have to take action?
Like, I don't know if that would help. I think that could affect us down the road for sure.
Keep it a secret, but they're learning.
Learning together, learning about respect, learning how to acquire knowledge, learning what matters and why it is important.
It's really fun to do these experiments.
We learn about the things we see every day, about the way the world works.
Climbing. The kids get inspired. What they learn in class brings the world around them to life. It's exciting for them and for me.
You play for each other, you play for your families, you play for that name that's on the front of your jersey right now. Leave it all on the field, man. Let's go, baby.
Athletics foster community. We learn from our setbacks, and together, we celebrate our victories.
We study hard and we play hard.
We're also creative. Fine arts, dramatics, and music.
Curtis London, you're being places!
The arts challenge our students, expanding who they are. They're gaining new skills and learning new talents that they didn't even know they had.
There's a lot going on, so we need to know how to take care of ourselves.
You know, exercise, eating well, meditation, and time management.
We count on each other.
We reach out to help each other.
We are part of a community.
And most important, the thread of integrity runs through everything we do. We're very proud of what we have here at 7. But buildings alone do not create a school. It's our community.
7 is so much more than I imagined. This is my place, my community.
At 7 School, we believe there are many ways to lead, and that each child has the potential to be exceptional. Because when we define leadership as the positive impact you can have on another person, we become the empathetic, dynamic people that ultimately the world will depend.
We'll be right back.
I'm gonna show you how great I am. Great I am. Great I am.
This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew.
I'm gonna show you how great I am.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate.
Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure.
The lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win.
Welcome to the MIA Lacrosse Game of the Week between your Severn Admirals, who come in today 13-5 and 4-5 in the MIAA Conference, versus St. Mary's, who's 15th ranked in the country according to the USA Top 25 rankings, and comes into today 6-3 in conference and overall 13-4. The Admirals suffered a devastating loss last game against number 22 Calvert Hall in a 10-6 defeat, which unfortunately ended their season's possibilities at playoff hopes. But as we all know, this rivalry has stakes high as ever all the time. It's not matter what the implications are. St. Mary's is locked into a playoff spot, but continuing to play for seeding. But both teams here today are playing for pride.
Always a very exciting game. Last year we played at St. Mary's, absolutely electric. Sophomore year, as you saw in the video earlier, if you were here with us for that, definitely electric. This game's always got something to show.
Yeah, just wait until zero.
Looks like we're gonna have a national anthem here.
Good afternoon and welcome to Barber Family Stadium for today's MIAA Game of the Week matchup between the visiting St. Mary Saints and your Severn Admirals. At this time, we ask everyone to please rise and remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem.
We are back. The Admirals, as I alluded to a couple minutes ago, suffered a loss last game, but the Admirals all year have done great after a loss, undefeated following a loss this season. See if they can keep that trend up today against a super talented St. Mary's team.
We're going to have an injury, though, missing key defenseman KJ Lloyd, the Bryan commit. Had a leg injury last game. He's going to be playing today.
With that being said, we're going to have a couple different starters here today.
So we got Will Perez in goal today. So the switch up. Jack Reed has been starting the last few games.
That's a big change in itself.
Definitely. Was not expecting that. Maybe switching it up after a loss. Not necessarily a bad idea. Both goalies obviously very capable. Willie Perez committed to Navy.
If not, don't worry about it.
And Jack Reed committed to Vermont.
Thank you, Wicker.
Both very solid, very talented goalies. And then on defense, to replace KJ, I believe they're going to have Bo Fowler back there. And then we got Aiden Shank as well as Jameson Wilt on the defense. Up on midfield, we got Chase Hallam, Tanner, Andrew Beard. And then on attack, we got Jacob Todd, Jackson Barrel, and Trey Dring. Trey Dring looking to get his 50th goal of the season today at 49. Absolutely electric season from number 27. Just looking to cap it off. Hit that big 5-0 on the year.
St. Mary's coming into this game with high stakes, though it's high stakes every time these two teams face off. St. Mary's is in the thick of the MIA conference. With a win here today, they could probably move themselves all the way up, maybe to potentially to the 2-seed, bearing matchup tiebreakers. With a loss today, they could fall all the way down to the 6-seed, which means they would have to play 3-seed currently right now, Loyola Blakefield. So a lot to play for St. Mary's, despite clinching a playoff spot. And Reed Gills is going to start a faceoff. The Admirals have 21 seniors on the roster. This team is experienced. They have 12 Admirals committed to play college lacrosse. They started 9-0 this year, which is their best start in more than 20 years. Despite this team not making the playoffs, this team is more than capable of knocking off a talented St. Mary's team today.
We've seen what they could play like against a team like Loyola. They are very capable. I'm excited to see what they're able to do today. Ref's still trying to figure it out. Excuse me, it's the TV people. I believe they have an ad break because it's nationally televised on ESPN. It's a little bit crazy. Hasn't been seen here at 7 in a long time, at least not since I've been here. Looks like we're going to finally get started.
St. Mary's
start. Plant.
They're going to push it early. Swing the ball, shot, score! St. Mary's starts quick. 1-0. Wow. That was quick. The Admirals are going to need to win the faceoff battle today if they're going to beat a talented St. Mary's team. St. Mary's was able to push the pace, catch the Admirals defense off guard, and score a goal early.
A little bit of a slow slide, it looked like there. Number 10 just got a perfect look.
Ryan
alluded to it if you're really Perez there.
Ryan alluded to it a couple minutes ago. A lot of changes in this Admirals defense.
Mason Irvin wins the draw.
Jameson Wilt's gonna bring it up.
Good clear from JMO there.
Andrew Beard now collects at the top. Goes to Chase Hallam.
Seven getting their subs in.
Admirals will start their offensive set. Tanner Huber now with the ball. Tanner Huber going to drive right. Pull it back left. Pass to Jacob Todd. Todd to Chase. Chase is going to go right. Continue to go right.
Down to Chase Barrel. Hallam looking for his 30th goal of the year at 29 too. Barrel tries to shoot. Didn't even get through to the goalie. Good defense there from St. Mary's.
St. Mary's is going to come the other way. The tempo in this game early is quick.
It's good physicality from Jackson Barrel there. Just wasn't quite nearly enough to get him out of bounds.
With Reed Gills doing faceoffs today,
senior Nick Sott is able to play in his natural position defensively. That helps them a lot here on this unit.
Quick move. Great save from Will Perez, his first of the game. Sutton looking to counter.
It'll be interesting to see how Will Perez plays today. He's been out, or he's hasn't started.
Quick move from Beard.
Beard pushed it, used his speed, turned left, fired, was unable to connect, though.
Just wide. Jackson Barrel is going to take it from behind the net.
A lot of people here today attending the game today. You can feel somewhat of a different buzz. Luke Hayes going to drive right. Luke Hayes going to fire.
It's high.
Too high for Luke Hayes. Jacob Todd going to work. Todd going to spin. Todd going to fire. And Todd scores in the bottom right corner. Jacob Todd.
Covering goal. Number 9, Jacob Todd. And his 45th of the season.
And that gives Jacob Todd his 81st point of the season and his 45th goal. Absolutely electric from the senior Princeton commit, Jacob Todd.
Just hopped off of one leg off the drive from behind the net. And slotted bottom right. That was beautiful.
Used his frame to get to his spot. Found that bottom right corner. Fired and scored. One all as the Admirals respond. Rico is at the faceoff.
Loose the clamp. It's Nick Sott with the ground ball. What a pretty ground ball from Nick Sott there. Reached somewhat, around the St. Mary's defender.
Somewhat of an ugly faceoff, but the Admirals were able to obtain possession. It's going to be a crucial part of this game today.
It's like Brad said earlier, face-offs are going to be very important. It's been killing the Admirals from the start of the year, not having real gills, obviously.
Chase Hallam now working at the top. Hallam going to drive right, pull it back out.
A little bit of an errant pass. It's bobbled. They keep it in bounds.
Beard now working. Beard's going to go left.
It's intercepted.
That was great defensive play from St. Mary's. And St. Mary's is going to push it the other way as they're going to have numbers.
Hotman rush. Great defense from Bo Fowler there.
St. Mary's is going to pull it out. St. Mary's a little stagnant, trying to get into their offensive set currently with 55 seconds left on the shot clock.
Finally got their subs in. Now they look to push. St. Mary's still with nothing. Shot clock's going to be down to 30 here. J-Mo slides over.
St. Mary's continuing to move the ball. Unable to find a look.
Errant pass. Recovered by St. Mary's.
Only 15 seconds left, and they haven't gotten a good look at it yet.
Quick move. Great save from Perez.
Fantastic save from Will Perez. Any questions about whether or not Will Perez would be ready early after not playing the last couple games? He's answered so far today.
A little bit of an errant pass from Nick Sott there. Just the kinds of turnovers that you don't want to see.
It's a crucial mistake the Admirals can't have against this talented St. Mary's team. St. Mary's going to continue to work.
They want a little bit of a shot clock as well.
He got to his,
waved off.
No good.
Hit the net, just not in the right way. One on the outside. It's going to be 7 ball here. Mason Irving going to try to get over midfield, and he does. St. Mary's coach, visibly upset. Mason Irvin.
Mason Irvin here going to work behind the goal.
That's going to be Davis Caulfield.
In the game. Back to Mason. Mason spins.
Good check from St. Mary's.
Neither team really able to get anything going in the half. set really early. St. Mary's only goal coming on a transition score where they push the pace. So it'll be interesting to see how these teams perform in the half. St. Mary's is going to take a timeout. And with 6:22 to go, it is 1-1 all. And we'll take a break of our own. We'll be back after this.
Righty, folks, welcome back. St. Mary's for the first time out of the game. Interested to see what they drew up here. Not quite sure why they called the timeout. Maybe they just wanted a little bit of a reset. Didn't really get the look they wanted on offense, but they have been playing pretty good defense, so I'm not quite sure why they called the timeout.
Since 2003, the Admirals trail the all-time series 13-5. But the last couple years, this rivalry has continued to heat it up. The games have continued to get even more competitive, especially between
great
these two
check.
Programs. Should be a good one today. And
two
here comes the
great
the other
checks
way.
From Nick Sott. Davis Caulfield's going to push it down the field with numbers. Looks for the shot, and
he
scores!
Davis Caulfield takes advantage of the numbers, bounces in the bottom
seven,
left
Davis
corner,
Caulfield.
And
this
he scores. And that's his eighth
goal
of the season for the senior. And the Admirals take a 2-1 lead. Fantastic response after a quick goal from St. Mary's to start this game.
Davis Caulfield gets the ground ball at the 40-yard line, takes it all the way to the opposite goal line, and slots it bottom left. Amazing play from the senior there.
If the Admirals are going to play, if the Admirals are going to continue to play fantastic defense, they have to capitalize on those numbers opportunities like they just did there.
Great clamp from Reed Gills there.
Admirals win the faceoff again. Doing pretty well in the possession game so far today. It's going to be something they need to keep up.
Chase Allen looks to make a move. Nothing there.
Chase Allen. Allen with Trey Dring.
Trey Dring, quick move.
Oh, Trey Dring tried to throw it low. Unable to get it past the goalie for St. Mary's, though. St. Mary's is going to come back the other way after a great defensive stop.
Aaron pass. St. Mary's recovers.
We've seen a couple errant passes so far.
A little bit chaotic, yeah.
A couple turnovers.
From both sides.
Looks a little, everyone maybe a little nervous, a little jitters. Got to get out.
Very important game for both sides here. One of the biggest rivalries in MIA.
These seniors,
nerves are obviously going to be
these seniors for the Admirals playing in their third game against St. Mary's in their high school career. 1-1. This is to give them the ultimate bragging rights. Good move.
Shots high. Nearly takes out a bystander there. Nobody hit, though, luckily. 20 seconds on the shot clock.
Ryan, can you think of any reason for the switchback back to Will Perez in the goal?
I honestly don't know. St. Mary's just going to throw it to the corner because they ran out of the shot clock. Maybe you just want to switch it up after a Calvin Hall loss.
I'm thinking maybe because it's Will Perez's final game and they want the senior experience in it. Like we already alluded to the jitters in this game. Maybe one of the experience of someone who's been in this game before.
Andrew Beard breaks his defender. You hear the Admirals bench getting a little hype for that. Nothing came out of it, though.
She's got the clear.
Admiral's going to work very slowly.
Taking their time here.
Andrew Beard going to work.
Shot is just wide. Severin's going to get the rebound, though.
Beard unable to connect on that look. Jackson Barrel.
30 on the shot clock.
Chase Allen going to work behind the goal.
Draws another defender.
Going to find Tanner Huber. Huber's going to go right.
10 seconds.
Hallam spin, fire, unable to connect. It's
right drain, Kim.
Couple seconds.
They're going to run it out here.
It's going to be a shot clock violation. Do not see many of these.
We're already seeing two today, one from both sides.
Fantastic defense from both teams to start. Also a little bit of sloppy execution offensively from both teams. We'll see who can settle in quicker.
Severn got some good looks. They just couldn't get it on goal. St. Mary's now going to look for an opportunity to tie this game up here. Still getting their subs in. Finally get it done.
Last time these two teams faced off, St. Mary's won 9-8 in a highly competitive game. That team was 17-3 last year. So despite how fantastic St. Mary's was, the Admirals continue to compete. That's just what you can expect between these two teams in this rivalry.
Down to 30. Good poke check from Shank there. Good switch off. Still gets around. Great save from Perez.
Will Perez has been fantastic early.
Reaching all the way across his body to make that stop. That was beautiful. Davis Caulfield loses the ball. It's checked out.
A problem with them with Will Perez and goal has been able to clear. Haven't
been
the best at that this
year.
Have to be able to get the ball over half and set your offense up.
And something that'll come with time here, I believe.
It feels like despite the Admirals winning the faceoff battle so far, they've lost the possession time. And
oh, that's a flag.
Getting a little chippy.
A little bit of a scuffle here. Bo Fowler not happy about that. I do not blame him. That was a blindside hit.
That was a tough hit.
Blindside, high near the head. It's not a safe play.
Rest discussing. You knew this game would be high intensity. But that was a statement made already in the first quarter.
I will say there's a difference between high intensity and just playing dirty hits. We hear it's non-releasable. We do not know how long it's going to be.
They're going to call a check to the head.
It is going to be a 3-minute non-releasable. Just about as bad of a penalty as you could take. Severn going to need to capitalize on this opportunity here.
This Admirals lacrosse team, a tight unit. Got a little chippy after that hit. Did not like seeing their teammate fall there.
Hopefully Davis Caulfield is okay. Already with a goal here today, a very important player for this team. Severn going to take it down the field here.
That might have knocked the jitters out of him.
Yeah.
Or in him. I don't know.
He's got to be pretty mad now.
Chase Hallam, the Beard. Beard, Tanner Huber. Huber back to Beard. Admiral swinging.
Fakes a shot.
Beard. And Beard scores! Admirals, perfect ball movements. Swung it side to side. Was able to get a good look with Andrew Beard. He stepped into it and he scored in the bottom right corner as the Admirals go up 3-1 with 26 seconds to go in the first.
And still plenty of time on the non-releasable. There's going to be a timeout here.
There's going to be a timeout here from. Here from the Admirals.
No. It's going to be a timeout for the national broadcast here.
My apologies.
It's a little bit different for us over here. We're not used to this kind of thing. We apologize.
The TV timeout. We'll take one of our own. We'll be back after this. Back. The Admirals just recently took a 3-1 lead, 26 seconds to go in the first. Have to capitalize on this man down time.
Still 2.5 minutes left, man. It's a long time for these St. Mary's Saints to be down here.
How do you suggest the Admirals best capitalize on this situation?
So, you don't need the quick shot. I would just wear them down and try to get the best look possible. You already got a goal out of it. Anything more from here,
so
just
icing
on top.
So a similar look to what you just got there from Beard. Continuing
exactly.
To move the ball and find the weak point.
Don't rush the shot. You don't want to give them any time to get possession. Reed Gills wins the clamp.
Reed Gills.
Breaks his defender. Oh, my goodness. Air pass, though.
And then throws it right to him. Admirals cannot afford.
Ball loose.
Admirals cannot afford those type of turnovers in this man down situation.
Luckily, the quarter is over.
That's going to end the first. An electric, intensity-filled first
end
quarter.
After
the
one
Admirals
quarter
3, St. Mary's 1.
St. Mary's 1.
We are back at the start of the second quarter. Good sign. Davis Caulfield is back into the game.
Still waiting on the national broadcast here. He's got his fist in the air in the middle of the 50-yard line. We have no idea what that means. I think it just means they're still running ads, but...
It's hold until they're allowed to run it.
Yeah. Why they're holding, we don't know.
Because they have TV time scheduled.
But
like they have commercials, and we just sit here and don't. Ryan, but, how many...
Why are they starting the corner?
How many national televised events have you gone to, like sporting events?
Not lacrosse games, I don't tell you that much.
No, but like, these things are still present.
I go to hockey games, I will say. You don't see anybody holding their fists out in the middle of the ice.
But they have TV timeouts delayed so that they can start rolling. But anyway, doesn't matter. We are back.
A little swim dodge there. Nearly stepped out of bounds. Nick Sott and J-Mo. Not giving him any space to breathe here. Just absolutely smothered. Not much they could have done there. Good defense from J-Mo and Nick Sott there.
Admiral's going to take it the other way. Still have a minute. Still have about a minute 30 over.
Andrew Beer is showing off that speed.
Admirals have to capitalize here. See if they can stretch this lead against a very good St. Mary's team to 3.
Andrew Beer just didn't even see the pass coming. Severn's just going to waste this away.
Admirals have to wake up a little bit.
The St. Mary's going to throw it away. Now they're going to get it back. Pass is bobbled. This is chaos.
Sloppy going on right now.
Bo Fowler gets the ground ball.
A lot is going on right now. The Admirals are going to take it back the other way.
Get to the Finn Kinsella. It was like 4 changes of possession in 20 seconds there. That was crazy.
45 seconds to go with this man up. Admirals need to capitalize here. Get one or two more good looks at this thing.
Trey Drink back on the field. Leading goal scorer for the Admirals. Embry Riddle commit.
These two teams are playing quick, but not effectively. And the Admirals score. Andrew Beer was able to make the entry pass to the cutting Jackson Barrel. And Barrel was able to finish it. And the Admirals take a 4-1 lead.
Another milestone there for Jackson Barrel. That's his 20th of the season. If you didn't hear from the PA announcement just there 5 seconds ago. Huge goal for the Admirals. Exactly what they needed off that 3-minute non-releasable.
Regals looks to take a huge face off here as the Admirals have 23 seconds left on this man up and would like to squeeze out one more good look.
It's entirely possible here with how Reed Gill's been winning these faceoffs. Gets it cleanly to Mason Irvin.
Admirals win. And
just runs over the Fogo.
Irvin.
You can hear Gavin Wicker laughing in the background here. Mason Irvin just destroys their Fogo.
Some would say mouse in the house. He's not a big boy either. He's small. That's all that basketball training in the off season we used to.
As the ballers would say, hit the weight room.
The man up is over, and the Admirals will now just possess. Chase Hallam working, using his frame.
Pass. Chase Hallam draws a double. A little bit of a forced pass there. Mason Irvin fighting for it.
A lot of physicality.
That was a bad penalty by Chase Hallam. I cannot believe he just did that. It was completely unnecessary. Severn's going to be the man down here
emotions
for at least a
minute. Emotions are running high. Tempo's running high. Turnovers, sloppiness. Also appearing at a high rate. It's not the prettiest action, but we're getting action. And with 9 minutes to go, the Admirals have a 4-1 lead.
Beautiful chaos, they might call it. Severn going to have to hold here.
The Admirals up 4-1. Don't even feel really settled into this game yet. Feel a little out of sorts, and they're still winning by 3. A great sign for the Admirals, and St. Mary's has to get it together soon before this game.
Great save from Perez again.
Will Perez is putting on a clinic currently.
It's a perfect look for the St. Mary's Saints there. Wide open up top. just from about 15 yards away. Willie Perez says no. It's only going to be a 30-second penalty on Chase Allen there. It's going to be a timeout for the Admirals. Not a national TV timeout. Got this one right this time. I apologize, folks. We'll be back with you in a minute here.
Back.
Severn man down here for 30 seconds. Will Huber back in the game, the senior. Love to see that. On the man down defense for the Admirals here, number 12. Shots high. St. Mary's got possessed though.
St. Mary's unable to convert though. Admirals have been great on this end so far today. Have to keep it up, though. Going to take a four-quarter effort.
Another high shot.
The Admirals getting out on shots, contesting the look, making the launch angles a little more difficult for these shooters from the outside. Just anything they can do to bother these shots before it gets to Will Perez in the goal. Another one.
That one's wide. It missed that. I don't know why that wasn't St. Mary's ball, but it's going to the Admirals. No complaints here. Willie Perez looking for options. Finds Beard. Great pass.
Beard slips, falls.
Recovers.
Mr. Dominic said you can turn it up a little bit.
I think we did. Severn going to get their subs in. Chase Allen back in the game, looking for his 30th goal of the season here.
Later in the game, later in the afternoon, the sun's out a little bit here nowadays.
Pretty
bad. Is that a behind the back pass? It's nice. Hallam's going to work from behind the goal.
Draws the double.
Go to Beard. Beard's going to go to Tanner. Tanner to Todd. Haven't seen a lot of Todd since that first goal. Todd's going to spin.
Draws two. Somebody's got to be open when they draw two defenders like that. Shot clock ticking 20 here.
Beard going to work.
Beard with a quick shot. Just high. The bouncer was pretty. Just a little too much.
15 seconds left. The Admirals need to work fast to find a good look.
10 seconds now. Chase Allen going to try to force something. Gets the spin.
Gets
it side.
Oh,
just wide.
Got a good look. Was falling away when he shot it. Unable to convert.
Severn going to take the shot clock violation here.
That's another one.
Good offense there from Severn. Shots just couldn't fall. St. Mary's looking to clear now. Good defense
there
from Severn. Wasting a lot of time.
Gonna work at the top.
Aaron pass. Still recovered.
A little bit sloppy on the pass there. Still able to control possession though. Great defense from the Admirals.
Shots wide.
Only going to be about 30 seconds left on the shot clock as the Admirals continue to play stout defense. Try to get that inside edge.
Shot clock down to 10. The shot's high again. It's off the 7 defense.
Bo Fowler came over for help. Jameson Wilt did a great job not giving up that inside edge to the goal. And St. Mary's West, 7 seconds left to quickly get off a shot. They're going to have to fire it here.
Great save from Perez.
Will Perez has been incredible in that goal so far today. Here comes Finn the other way.
Good clear from Finn Kinsella. Running the length of the field.
Jacob Todd now works at the top.
Finn Kinsella just doing all the dirty work for the Admirals, getting it across, doing his job, playing defense. Love to see it from number 4, the senior.
Gettysburg commit.
Quick pass to Trey Dring. That's going to be his 50th of the year.
Trey Dring. Beautiful pass to Trey.
Trey
finished it, and that's numero 50 on the year for Trey Dring. And the Admirals go up 5-1. Electricity, folks.
Believe there's another timeout here. Waiting to see who it's from.
This might be a TV one.
It's going to be a TV timeout.
Yep.
We'll be back with you in a minute here, folks.
We are back, and the Admirals have, not really arguably to me, played the best 20 minutes of lacrosse they've played almost all year.
Thriving in that chaos.
Questions about the nervousness of this game.
Jacob Todd with a quick shot!
Jacob Todd!
7 goals,
bounced
number 9,
top
Jacob
left
Todd.
Corner, and
his
he scores!
Of the game, 46
and
of
the Admirals
year.
Go up 6-1.
What a start here for the Admirals,
Absolute electricity, folks. Jacob Todd puts in his second of the game and gives the Admirals a 6-1 lead with 4:46 to go in the second. Ryan, I wonder, how does the TV timeouts, the media stoppages after goals maybe affect the momentum of these two teams, and is it affecting the Admirals at all currently?
They're working some magic, clearly, man. Reed Gill is also just winning these face-off clamps is helping a ton. Reed Gill is still able to make it happen. Jacob Todd gets the ground ball, and the Admirals are going to call a timeout just to make sure they maintain the possession there. It's a good call from Coach Christie. We'll be back with you folks here in a minute.
We are back. Though there might have been a couple complaints from my color commentator about the TV timeouts, I've needed one because I need to catch my breath. This game has been absolutely electric for the Admirals side.
Hey, man, not complaints. I was just confused, all right? Yeah, laugh all you want. I know.
Admirals going to have possession as Regals has been dominating the face-off battle. Jackson Barrel going to work, going to get a pick from Mason Irvin.
It's like we said earlier, those face-offs are key.
They have absolutely controlled the tempo and the pace and possession of the ball in the last eight-minute stretch as the Admirals have continued to stretch this lead.
Mason Irvin draws a double. Takes the contact.
Great defense from St. Mary's so far. About 30 left on the clock.
Davis and Caulfield looking for a window. Nothing there. Quick dodge.
20 on the shot clock.
20
under
left.
20 now.
20 left on the shot clock. The Admirals need to find a good look. Trey Drang, drive.
Ball loose. Crease violation. It's going to be St. Mary's ball.
Not a lot going there offensively for the Admirals as St. Mary's responds out of the timeout. Plays great defense. Let's see how they perform coming back the other way.
Good slides there from St. Mary's.
The St. Mary's team is ranked 15th in the top 25 for a reason. This team has a great ability to respond. Let's see if they can today.
Little thing we haven't mentioned here earlier. I believe St. Mary's had the first goal of the game, so the Admirals on a 6-0 run here. In this first half.
That goal came quickly within about the first 25 seconds. Since that vantage point, Admirals have been dominant.
Nothing's happened here.
It's going to take a four-quarter effort.
Game is certainly not over. Shots wide.
Will Press has been great in goal today, but not a lot of on-target shots for St. Mary so far today.
And that's a testament to the Admirals' defense. Nothing easy through those boys.
Play great defense against the guy trying to cut down in the middle of that defense. St. Mary's going to go behind the net.
Shot clock down to 15 here. St. Mary's needs something to happen. Down the 10.
Continuing to move the ball side to side, trying to find something. They're going to
get five.
Open
they
up.
Get a look here. It's high, unable though.
Unable to convert. The
2 seconds on the clock here. St. Mary's just going to let it go.
That's going to be a shot clock violation. That's the fourth of the game so far in the first half. Both these teams have been fantastic defensively in the half court. Half field sets.
St. Mary's dad's audibly upset on the sideline here. Finn draws her defenders, passes it perfectly to Nick Sott. Great clear from the Admirals there. Obviously one of the struggles throughout the season. Making it happen here. Carter Johnson shoves off a defender.
A lot of physicality these two teams playing with today. The Admirals have just matched that challenge just a lot better than St. Mary's so far.
That hit on Davis Caulfield in the first quarter just seemed to have ignited this team. St. Mary's trying to get in their heads, and Admirals just not having any of it.
Both these teams a little sloppy on these passes. Ball movement. 30 seconds left on the shot clock. Chase Hallam at the top, going to get a pick.
Still looking for his 30th of the season. Maybe gets it here. Nothing there.
Luque is going to work at the top, 15. Got to get something going here.
Down to 10.
Luque is going to drive. The drive.
Nice
and
shot
scored.
From Hayes.
Luke Hayes is going to score, and that's now 7-1 for the Admirals. With 56 seconds to go in the first half, that's Luke Hayes' sixth on the season and first of the game. Absolute nails.
Franklin and Marshall commit.
Used his big body frame and his physicality to get in the spot he wanted, and he finished.
St. Mary's trying to be physical. Luke Hayes, all for it.
Hayes was unable to find anybody else. With 15 seconds on the clock, had to look down and go drive himself, taking himself, and he converted. The Admirals now go up 7-1 with 56 seconds left to go.
It's going to be a violation on St. Mary's. Another face-off win for the boys here. And that's been killer if you're a fan of the Saints.
It's important to see how these two teams close out the half as the Admirals can hold for last shot.
With that goal from Luke Hayes, that's going to make it a 7-0 run for the Admirals. St. Mary's not able to get anything on offense. And while Severn has looked a little bit sloppy at times, they have converted when they needed to. And that's been the difference maker here.
30 seconds left on the clock, on the shot clock, or game clock, excuse me.
Looking for the last shot here.
Jackson Barrel's going to hold it at the top.
Still waiting.
They're about to go into their set with about 15 seconds to go. Mason Irvin's going to drive. They have 10 seconds, don't have a lot of time. Carter Johnson.
Carter Johnson draws the push.
They're going to call a loose ball push, and with 3.8 seconds to go, the Admirals have to work quickly.
They try to force it in, there's nothing there.
And that will conclude the first half. The Admirals have arguably played the best half of lacrosse this season, but it's going to take a two-half effort. Admirals 7, St. Mary's 1. And that'll conclude the first half, and we'll be back after this halftime break. We are back for the start of the second half. To recap the first half, the Admirals have a 7-1 lead. Multiple goal scorers. Jacob Todd has two. Trey Dring has one. Beard's got a couple. It's been an incredible performance so far today. Luke Hayes has one. Sorry, Beard has one, excuse me. And Barrel has one. To spread out the wealth of scoring early. But I think the real story so far has been the face-off battle with Reed Gills absolutely dominating so far in the first half, and then the defense in the half set. Will Perez, starting his first game in the last couple, has absolutely showed up and showed out here for the Admirals today. The Admirals are playing well on both ends, but it's starting defensively.
Reed Gills lost one faceoff to start the game and hasn't looked back since. Seems like he hasn't lost one since that first faceoff. Been absolutely dominant at the dot for the Admirals. Still waiting on the TV here. I did get it right this time, guys. Still holding.
The Admirals have not only dictated possession, have been great defensively, and have capitalized offensively on open shots. One of their best first half performances or stretches of 24 minutes all season for them. The Admirals this year have a 19-8 record against St. Mary's in sports. And there we go. You knew St. Mary's would come out here with a little bit of an attitude. Come out here with a little bit of a sense of urgency. And the fans are getting into it for St. Mary's on the other end. You knew they wouldn't go down quietly. That's not this type of rivalry. That's not this type of team. The Admirals are going to have to respond. But we saw this story to start the first half. That's their first goal in over 23 minutes.
Almost the exact same start as the start of the game.
The Admirals didn't get rattled when they were down 1-0. Let's see if they can keep it together as St. Mary's tries to apply a lot of pressure on this comeback.
Mason Irvin dodges out of a quadruple team.
Yeah, St. Mary's, you can see, playing with a little bit of an attitude to start the second half, a sense of urgency, quicker to the ball. Matching that intensity that we talked about in the first half, the Admirals were out physicality them. And let's see if the Admirals can settle into the second half and respond.
It seems like St. Mary's has been trying to push the level of physicality, and the Admirals have been playing well when they have responded.
Absolutely. Tanner Huber going to work at the top. Huber's going to go right. Huber to Jackson Barrel.
I'll bring up that play from the first quarter when they had the blindside hit on number 7, Davis Caulfield.
The Admirals cannot be settled with this lead. The St. Mary's team is way too talented for 7 goals to be the final target score.
Really ignited them. They need that spark back here.
Beard's going to pull it out. Beard's going to go left, get a pick from Todd. Beard to Chase Hallam. 15 seconds left on the clock. Hallam's got to go to work. Hallam
Chase
spins.
Hallam.
Fakes
one.
Fires. That was a good look. Unable to convert. That was a look that they were able to convert in the first half.
Chase Hallam, you can see, hungry for that 30th goal. Third leading scorer on the team. Very talented player.
You'd love to see
him getting involved early here.
It's going to take 4 quarters for the Admirals.
St. Mary's got numbers here. Admirals recover.
Great defense. St. Mary's going to have to pull it out.
Admirals need to continue to stay solid here.
Anything you saw in the first half, Ryan, that gave the Admirals the advantage that St. Mary's needs to clean up in the second half?
Yeah.
What are those things?
I couldn't hear you. I'm sorry.
I said any things you saw in the first half that the Admirals did well that St. Mary's has to clean up in the second half to come back.
Like I said earlier, it's just that physicality. Like Nick Saad just showed off right there. St. Mary's thrives off of being the more physical team. And not just in lacrosse, in all sports, really. If you can match that or even out-physical physically beat them, then, like, you can win. I will say experience from basketball, too. Big team, a lot of size. They thrive off of that. You take that away from them, they've got nothing. I apologize, folks. It's really loud out here. It's even hard to hear my commentator to the left of me here. We're only 5 feet apart, and I can barely hear him.
Mason Irving going to work at the top. Barrel. And that's...
another errant pass.
That's a missed pass. We see a couple of those in the first half. And that one led to a turnover. Admirals have to continue to apply the pressure and execute if they want to pull this one out. Not exactly the same story, but just a week ago, we saw the Admirals dominate for about 3.5 quarters against Loyola and go up 3 goals. They played excellent on both ends. They settled a little bit. The other team got a little bit comfortable. The Admirals cannot do that against the St. Mary's team today.
I agree. Don't let up. Oh, and it just squeezes through. Perez got a stick on it, but it just barely squeezes by. Unfortunate break for the Admirals there.
That's going to be a goal from St. Mary's, and that's one that Will Perez wish he had back. It's now 7-3, but the Admirals need to stay steady and need to be able to respond. And a big part of that is going to be Reed Gills here at this faceoff.
Reed Gills obviously been stellar at the dot. Fighting for it here.
Reed Gills lost the faceoff, and you can feel the momentum slightly turning. Admirals have to settle in. Have to respond.
I won't say the momentum's turning yet. Keep the good mojo in the air. 2-0 run's not uncommon.
Admirals need to stop the bleeding here a little bit. And that's going to start with getting possession and then executing on the offensive end. But it starts in that circle with Rekills.
Wow,
the sun is really out here.
I did not
bring sunscreen. Wasn't prepared for that. May need it. A little toasty up in the booth. Great defense from Davis Caulfield.
Davis Caulfield not letting up.
Davis Caulfield's played great today.
Shots wide.
Great contest from Nick Sott to make the shooter uncomfortable. There's 20 seconds left on the shot.
Perez did not know where that went.
St. Mary's tried to do the behind-the-back shot. Unable to convert. Here comes.
Admirals
with
numbers.
The other way. Admirals going to pull it out.
Smart play. You don't need the goal. Take your time. Maybe get a better look. Severin with their subs in now. Chase Allen. Still with it. Doubled. Breaks free. Drives in.
Oh.
It's just high.
Chase Hallam saw an angle, got that inside positioning, was unable to convert. And with about 30 seconds left on the shot clock.
St. Mary's chanting air ball.
Don't understand that one.
It's a little bit ironic after their first half performance of barely hitting the goal at all, but you know. Whatever makes him happy, I guess. Jackson Barrel. Just taking it all the way. Shots wide, though.
Credit to St. Mary's fans. Haven't been a lot to cheer for so far today, but they're getting into it currently. There's about 14 seconds left on the shot clock. The Admirals, an Admirals goal here would go a long way.
Ah, errant pass.
And here comes St. Mary's the other way.
Good hustle from Lucas to get back there. Good slide from Bo.
5:26 to go. St. Mary's outscoring the Admirals 2-0 this period. Or this quarter, excuse me.
St. Mary's still got subs getting. Finally get it done.
St. Mary's not rushing. continuing to play at their pace. They have plenty of time as they've cut this lead down to 4.
Quick shot. Great save from Perez.
Great defense from Will Perez. And they have to be able to clear here.
Casey Gaddy, the sophomore, to J-Mo. Back to Perez. Great clear from the Admirals there. Clean and crisp passing. Goes a long way. Jacob Todd splits the defense.
Jacob Todd's going to go to work. 4:25 to go in this third period. Todd to Mason. Mason to Tanner Huber. Huber's going to drive right.
30 left on the shot clock. Jacob Todd drawing the entire defense, it feels like.
Todd's going to spin.
Spin. Finds Merv. Ooh. It's on goal. You're going to get a reset there.
Quick shot from Mason Irvin. Beautiful pass from Todd. An okay look.
They should get a reset. They're not going to get it. That was clearly a shot on goal. Down to 15 now. Jacob Todd still gets a shot off.
They're going to call
a flag. He draws
the flag.
As his helmet gets knocked off. I believe that's a 1 minute. Another check to the head. Severin backing the man up. With 2 goals on the man up so far in this game. Very strong. They need one here. Trey Dring almost had a good look. Pass is bobbled. Beard recovers.
That's going to be a turnover. And here comes St. Mary's the other way. Unable to convert.
Shot
St. Mary's playing with a lot of tempo. Have been great on the defensive end this period. Have to be able to convert for St. Mary's, though, if you want to cut this lead. Admirals continue to have this man up.
St. Mary's going to run the clock out, though. Time has expired for the man up of the Admirals.
It's going to be important these two teams close out the quarter well.
Bo Fowler, good defense. Oh, wide up in front.
That's way too easy. Beautiful ball movement from St. Mary's. Able to make the entry pass. Easy look, and they converted. And it's now 7-4 Admirals.
And we're going to have a TV timeout here. Obviously, not a great start to the third quarter for the Admirals. This is going to be a much-needed break for them. St. Mary's chanting, talk it over, down 3 goals. I don't know where they get this stuff from, honestly.
Well,
you're supposed to do that when you're winning.
Well, talk it over is fine, but we didn't call a timeout. TV did.
That is also
and so
true.
That's my,
you know, it's a little strange.
That's my thing where it's just like, you know, we actually technically didn't want to.
Right. But, you know.
But it's okay.
They can do what they want. We're not going to judge them. Yes, we will,
you're
honestly.
Judging,
okay. All right. We'll be back with you in a minute here.
We are back with 2:32 to go. The Admirals desperately need to win this face-off, and they need to respond, gain some momentum back the other way.
See if Rick Gills can get it going here. He cannot. Still fighting for it. It's loose. It's going to be possessed by Aiden Shank. Not a clean win, but a win's a win regardless. It feels like it's what the Admirals need to get going in this game. Andrew Beard draws two, finds Davis. Davis with numbers. Nothing there. I believe he was resetting the shot clock there. Yes, he was. Up to 60 now. Chase Allen drawing two defenders.
St. Mary's being a lot more physical in the second half, matching that intensity.
Davis Caulfield.
It's a tough look. I don't understand the air ball.
Chance. Yeah, I don't really get it, especially when half your shots have been off target.
Oh!
Too. Jacob Todd gets triple teamed.
St. Mary's quick to the ball, crowding the man with the ball. They have completely ramped up this intensity in the second half. They're making the Admirals uncomfortable currently. They're now only down three.
That's on Coach Christy to adjust to that, though. Those doubles and triple teams have got to leave somebody open. You got to be able to find those open players. They can't allow those triple teams to work.
I feel like despite the TV timeout just called, I feel like the Admirals do need to potentially call one if this game gets cut to two. Admirals just seem a little bit rattled. They couldn't have thought that the St. Mary's team would just go down and let this game be over.
Quiet the storm a little bit here. You get a stop, that's huge. That's all you need. You go into the third quarter. Still up three goals.
Admirals have to.
It's not massively, but it's a comfortable one.
Admirals have to get back to that intensity they brought in the first half.
Air ball, as the St. Mary's fans would say.
Seconds left on the game clock. The shot clock only 15, so they can't hold for last shot. They need to find a good one. Admirals need a huge stand here to get some momentum going into the third.
Another air ball.
St. Mary's unable to convert. The Admirals are going to have possession with 13 seconds to go.
I'm sorry, folks. 12 seconds left here. Seven can get an opportunity. They might just try to wait it out, though. It looks like that's what they're going to do.
They're going to try to cross the half line so they can possess it. Second half.
And Seven holds on to that three-goal lead.
And the score after three quarters of play, 7-7, St. Mary's 4.
At the end of three, the Admirals have a 7-4 lead. St. Mary's has outscored the Admirals by three in that third quarter, 3-0. Let's see how the Admirals respond as the fourth quarter of this game is coming up next. start of the fourth quarter between the Severn Admirals and the St. Mary's Saints. St. Mary's 15th ranked team in the top 25 clinched the playoff spot. The Admirals are officially eliminated of this playoff spot. But this game just means a lot to these two teams in this rivalry. Admirals came into the second half with a 7-1 lead, had not been able to put the ball in the goal in the second half yet as we enter the fourth quarter and the Admirals only have a 3-possession lead.
I think it's a testament to how important those face-offs are. Reed Gillis obviously went on a streak where he won like 8 or 9 in a row, and that lead just kept on building. Reed Gillis kind of mellowed out a little bit, won a couple, obviously lost a couple too.
It's definitely one of the stories for the Admiral struggles in the third quarter is Reed Gillis'
violation. Going to be on St. Mary's.
It's going to be huge.
Once again, not a clean win, but a win is a win. We will always take it.
Jacob Todd. Admirals have to play a four-quarter game. Have to execute late. Unable to make that pass to Trey Drain cutting. And it's going to go the other way. That is another turnover.
Feels a little unnecessary, if I say so.
The story for the Admirals in this third quarter, empty possessions offensively. Just not been able to get... I don't know how many shots they even took in that third quarter. Unable to get good looks at the thing.
And, you know, they had plenty of time left to the shot clock. I don't think he needed that pass there. It's a little bit risky. If you're going to make that pass, you're going to be 100% sure it's going to connect because those will always lead to turnovers.
Admirals have to continue to be stout defensively as their offense has become a little stagnant.
This Admirals defense has felt like it's been the life of the team so far this year. I don't know, I shouldn't say so far, throughout this year. It's going to need to be the life of this team in the fourth quarter.
Couple unexpected pieces playing on this unit today. And yet they've still been outstanding. Have to play four quarters, though.
Great save from Perez as the rebound.
That's so unfortunate. Will Perez played great defense on somewhat of an open shot on the first. Ricochet went back to St. Mary's. They shot and they scored. It's now 7-5 with 10:44 to go in the fourth. Slowly brewing, but the tide has completely shifted in this game in the second half. The Admirals need a response. They need something to stop the bleeding. They need something to get their bleachers back into this ballgame.
That's going to be a 4-0 run for the Saints here. Not a good look for the Admirals.
It starts with Reed Gillis in this circle right here. Admirals have to dominate possession in the final 10:44. The Admirals win again.
Another violation on St. Mary's.
Have to be able to execute now that you obtain possession. Need open looks at the thing.
St. Mary's chirping Bo Fowler a little bit. Bo Fowler's all for it. Three-sport athlete. He's no stranger to a little bit of trash talk. Jacob Todd looking for something. There's nothing there. Quick move. Shots high. Jacob Todd immediately recovers.
Decent cut from...
Coach Christie calls a timeout.
Great timeout from the Admirals. Regroup. As St. Mary's likes to say, talk it over. And with 9:57 to go, the Admirals had to settle into this one.
We are back.
With 9:57 to go in this intense, physical fourth quarter, Denver's going to have possession up two. Need to capitalize on this end.
St. Mary's just doubling Dodd, it seems like.
St. Mary's has completely brought it to the Admirals physicality-wise. Admirals need to get an open look at this thing. Haven't had many of them in the second half.
Should get a reset there. It's on goal. They're not going to get it.
That's going to be a shot clock violation. It's going to go the other way.
There's a flag down on the field. Coach Christie visibly upset there. Did not get the shot clock reset.
Admirals have to stay resilient. 9:22 to go. This can't be a game they think they hold off one. They have to go win it. St. Mary's is playing loose. They're playing with physicality. They're playing with an intensity. The Admirals need to match it quickly.
Will Huber back on for the man down. Wide open up in front.
St. Mary's made the entry pass. The Admirals were unable to defend it with a man down. And St. Mary's has now cut it to one score. 7-6 with 9:05 to go. We talked about that 7-0 run the Admirals had after the first goal score from St. Mary's to begin the game. And St. Mary's has now responded with five straight to make it 7-6. The Admirals need a response. And it's gonna start here with Reed Gills.
The Saints starting a long pull on attack.
It currently feels like a slow bleed out right now. Admirals just continuing to slip away.
Reed Gills gets tripped up.
They're going to call penalty on St. Mary's.
Severn looking to respond here. Jacob Todd scores!
Jacob Todd! I was just about to ask the question, who would be the one who stopped the bleeding, and it would be no one else other than Jacob Todd, senior Princeton commit, makes a
Severn
huge goal,
goal
and a huge response as the Admirals take a two-goal lead, 8-6.
Todd's third goal of the game, 47th of the year. Attention fans, if you are parked at the Vet Center, you need to move your vehicle immediately as they are beginning to tow vehicles.
That's a little bit crazy. There's a tow truck coming if your vehicle is parked by the veterinarian's office. Just a little bit of a heads up. I know you folks watching probably aren't at the game. Just in case you are, though. Reed Gills gets another clean win.
Huge face-off win. The Admirals need to build in this momentum. Let's see if they can string together a couple good offensive sets. As that goal felt like a huge pressure off the backs, taken off, lifted on this Admirals offense.
You stopped the bleeding. Now you got to go on the offensive. Let's see what they can do here. Chase Hallam tries to shoot it. It's high.
Okay, look. Unable to convert. On the St. Mary's proclaimed air ball.
Air ball chance coming back out. It's unique, I'll give him that. Another Aaron Passman, Carter Johnson.
Not really, if it's used in other sports.
It's not using the cross, though. That's what I meant. Jack Giardino, our tech guy, waving his head no. Former lacrosse player, I'll take it from him. Jacob Todd, quick shot. It's saved.
Admirals have to get back defensively.
Goalie tries to do a little bit too much. Now he's out of the net. Sever with an opportunity to counter here. Trey wide open.
What? Oh, no. Trey Drink.
Why would he not shoot that?
Had a turnover.
Wide open net.
I think he was trying to make a pass to capitalize on the open net. They were unable to convert. The turnovers for both teams, but more for the Admirals, have been a story all day with the sloppy passes. And that was a major opportunity that the Admirals just missed there.
Need those. They start to add up. We've seen a few of those kind of sloppy mistakes.
If this game was to go to extra time, or St. Mary's was to win, this would be a point.
Player down here. We're going to go to break.
We are back.
Hopefully Mason Irvin's okay. Looked like it was just a cramp, but
a little humid outside today.
Yeah. It was raining, like a little drizzle just 2 hours ago. Now it's bright sunny.
Someone might need to hand him a banana.
It's a classic Maryland weather case there, you know. I've seen it be 20 degrees and then 70 the next. It's not unusual. Shot from St. Mary's. On target, Willie Perez says no.
Great stop from the Admirals. Have to be able to clear it the other way, though.
Next stop finds Bo Fowler. Who finds Finn Kinsella. Finn Kinsella trying to take it to the net.
Trey Drink's going to gather up to Beard. 6:20 to go.
Chase Hallam waiting for the subs to come in.
Jackson Barrel gonna work. Carter Johnson.
Johnson just forces it a little too much. Nothing there. Another turnover.
Admirals have to come back the other way. St. Mary's gonna have numbers. And that's a goal. St. Mary's capitalizes, goes quick, and it's now 8-7. St. Mary's cuts it back to 1 with 5:36 to go.
We're gonna have a TV timeout here.
And that's gonna be a media timeout. A much needed break for the Admirals. We're going to take one of our own. We'll be back after this. are back. And a huge face-off here from Reed Gills. St. Mary's just cut it to one. And this second half, capitalizing on the Admirals' lack of execution on the offensive end.
Reed Gills going to shoot off the post. Davis Caulfield fighting for it.
Here comes St. Mary's the other way. That's not good. They're going to have numbers, and they're going to push it. They're going to fire. Unable to convert. Now both teams.
Bo Fowler gets the rebound. Huge from number 40. He waves off to the fans. You love to see it. That's huge from the big fella, number 40.
Nick Sott just takes it all the way through. It's checked out of his hands, though.
And it's going to be another turnover.
Uh-oh. They're going to have numbers. Unable to convert again for St. Mary's. It's felt like multiple times they've had multiple chances at making this entire
and
game.
And it's going to be a crease violation on St. Mary's.
Going to take it the other way.
St. Mary's going to call a timeout here.
Both teams a little frantic, a little rattled. That was a crazy minute. But we're going to St. Mary's is going to take a timeout. We'll take one of our own. We'll be back after this. We are back as the Admirals lead 8-7. An interesting note, last meeting I alluded to earlier, St. Mary's won 9-8. At the end of three quarters, the Admirals led 7-5. At the end of three quarters today, the Admirals have led 7-5.
Hey, a situation they're putting bad mojo in the air. Stop that.
What?
We lost that game, right?
Correct.
You're putting bad mojo in the game. It's 8-7 right now.
I'm just saying we've been in this situation before.
Right. That's fine. Don't manifest that. We don't need that right now. They're drawing offsides. Severin is just making a lot of unforced errors here, and it's costing them.
They just seem so frantic and a little nervous here, trying to hold on to the win instead of just going to go win it. Kind of hoping that the time's their friend here. We're 4 minutes to go. St. Mary's has plenty of time.
Something we forgot to mention earlier. It's good to see Mason Irvin back on the field. Looks like it was just a cramp. Good defense from J-Mo. Ball's loose.
Jameson.
Ground ball from Davis.
Davis is going to come the other way. Have to capitalize on the turnover.
Finds Barrel behind the cage. Severin's going to settle down here.
Admirals need a good look here. This is a huge.
Offsides on St. Mary's.
It's a huge offensive set here with 3:15 to go and the Admirals leading by one. Need to have a good look here.
You know, Brad, if you're Coach Christie, you take this flag. You're going to take all the time in the world here. You run it down to zero, and you get an extra 60 to shoot after that.
So no matter what, they're firing around the zero mark.
Right. You want to waste as much time as possible with this lead here. And this looks like it's what the Admirals are going to try to do.
With the opportunity, they might as well try to get a good look out of it, though.
For sure.
20 left on the shot clock. St. Mary's seems a tad content with that as well.
No pressure here. Good move from Chase Allen, but he gets the crease violation.
He's in the crease. But the flag still applies.
Will not matter, though, because Severn's going to get the ball right back from the flag with an extra 60 seconds here. It's going to be an illegal procedure on St. Mary's.
This place would have been jumping if that goal would have counted.
Don't want to say it would have been the dagger, but
another
it would have 60 been brutal
seconds for
St. Mary's.
Another 60 seconds for the Admirals. If they windle it down and find a good shot, that'd put them around a minute 30 left in this game.
It's going to be a 30-second penalty. The Admirals, you'd like to get one here, but you cannot afford any unforced turnovers anymore.
Need a good look here. Admirals' defensive unit has been fantastic all game.
Looks like there's a little bit of a miscommunication between the refs. They're going to talk it out. Play's going to resume here.
Here we go, folks. Final 2:30. Admirals have possession.
Who's going to be the one to step up? Trey Dring off the crossbar!
Trey Dring went off the crossbar, and he didn't use a lot of time in the clock. That is not ideal.
And Andrew Beer takes a flag.
And Andrew Beer's going to get a flag. This is not ideal for the Admirals.
St. Mary's going to possess. Now they're going to have an opportunity. Once again, just another one of those unforced errors. Andrew Beard with a little bit of a high check against the helmet. That's all it's going to take. Now the Saints can run the
clock. If St. Mary's ties this game, that slight missed shot from Trey Drink.
He's going to wish he had that one back. This is going to be the man-up unit. This is one of their biggest possessions of their seasons here. It's going to be a 30-second. It's going to be a timeout for the Admirals.
The Admirals are going to take a much-needed timeout. With a minute 24 to go, the Admirals still hold on to a one-score lead.
Alrighty, folks. Interesting development here. We are actually two men down. On top of the slash, the Admirals were offsides.
This is not good. St. Mary's has to move the ball, space it out, find that open man, and they have to convert the shot here. Not an ideal situation for the Admirals. Have to survive this time. Two down.
And they can't.
And that's a goal from St. Mary's, and it is 8-all with 1:05 to go. The Admirals desperately need to win this faceoff and control possession.
Still a man down.
That's even more why they need to win this possession right here. This is huge.
Excuse me, they are not man down.
It is.
It gets wiped off.
It is never easy in this rivalry. It is 8-all with 1:05 to go. If you were a viewer of the stream, or you're here in this game today, this is all you could ask for. 8-8, 1:05 to go. Here we go, folks.
It's a battle. Goes out to St. Mary's. They haven't possessed it yet. Still biting. Ball's loose. Still loose. Nick Saw fighting for it. Still loose. Mason Urban finally gets it. He loses it. And it's going to be Saints ball.
Oh, my goodness, folks. 36 seconds to go. St. Mary's can have last shot. Nervous here up in the booth. What's the look here for St. Mary's, Ryan?
Take it at 20. Make something happen. This looks like exactly what they're going to do.
Go. Trying to look for an open man. Not going to find it. Have a man work up top.
Great stop from Perez. That's huge. Aaron Clear. And that's going to do it, folks. We have got overtime.
Unbelievable stop from Will and Perez. And regulation wasn't enough time to decide who's going to win this game. 8-8 all, and they're just going to take a short, brief break. What a game to be showcased for the MIAA Game of the Week. We're going to take a break of our own. We'll be back after this. Here we go, folks. We are back, and it is overtime as Reed Gills goes to face off in the inner circle.
Hey, you know, Admirals probably should have had it in hindsight.
Each team will have one timeout.
This is no better way to end the season. This is it's exciting as it gets. Reed Gills gonna win the clamp. That's huge for the Admirals. They're not calling timeout.
Jesus Christ, why did it take so long?
The Admirals.
I don't care.
Admirals, one possession, found themselves in a tad bit of trouble, but they're going to call themselves a timeout, gather themselves, and with 3:49 to go, the Admirals are going to have a good look at it. We are back. Score is 8-8 in OT. The last time these two teams met, the final score was 9-8. That's possible. The last time these two teams met here in Admiral Stadium, the Admirals won 10-9 in overtime. Both those things will have to happen one way or the other today.
I was there the game they won. Admirals, Connor Layden, senior at the time. Absolutely magnificent goal. Let's see who's going to be the one to step up here.
You've got to think this is one of the best opportunities they're going to get.
For
sure. With 3:30 to go. Todd's going to get pushed out. They're going to find Beard.
Beard gets in! Oh, it's just wide.
Admirals recover, though, with 40 seconds left. It was a great look at it, unable to convert, but the Admirals are going to regroup. And they're going to work with about 30 left on the clock. Trey Drink, unable to convert. They got the ricochet.
They're going to get the reset.
And they're going to get the reset.
We got it, we got it.
And there's going to be a stoppage.
We got it. They got it right this time.
They're calling back the reset.
They're calling back the reset. Admirals have not gotten the reset calls today. Here we go. Let's see what they can work with 20 seconds left.
Jacob Todd trying to cut in.
It's turnover, and it's going to go the other way. And here comes St. Mary's. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
St. Mary's now with an opportunity to ice the game.
2:35 to go. 8-all. This game is absolutely electric. Nervousness on both sides and in the booth. Let's see what St. Mary's can come up with 2:22 to go. They're going to go right. 24 is going to go to the left. Fire! And he scores! St. Mary's has won it! He walks it off, and here they come all on the field. That's it. The Admirals had a 7-1 lead at halftime, and they lost it. 9-8 St. Mary's, and what a brutal way for the Admirals to end their season. St. Mary's rushing the field. Incredible shot, incredible finish. What a game.
Yeah, you know, just the classic St. Mary's class.
And St. Mary's is running over and ripping off the Sink the Saints shirt. Wow, what a game, folks. Unbelievable start from the Admirals. Unbelievable finish from St. Mary's. This is what you come to expect from an MIAA game of the week. Heartbreaking finish for our seniors. Incredible year, incredible team. 21 seniors on the team. Not the way they wanted to finish their high school career in lacrosse.
It's about as brutal of a way to go out as there is. I will say the Admirals had every chance to win that game. That's one that's going to sting for a long time.
Admirals played really well. St. Mary's, 15th ranked team in the country. Going to look ahead into the playoffs. This is a great team. This was a great game. Unbelievable. I'm Brad Strauss. I'm here along with
Ryan Stewart.
And we're going to sign off. That's the last broadcast of the year. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Peace out.